A very good morning, all of you. Welcome to our final 5 a.m. club, day 7, 7-day challenge. So, how are you guys doing? I hope you had a pleasant night's sleep. So, let's go ahead with our 5 a.m. session. So, first, we'll start with a few minutes of meditation, and then we'll go ahead with some important topics related to dental caries, where we'll have some illustrations, and also I'll be leaving out some critical thinking questions. And we'll have MCQs discussion from caries and fluorides in today's final dinner session. I hope you guys are all ready. And also, I hope the streaming is fine. Let me know if you have any issues with streaming or audio. Okay, guys, so I hope you're awake. So let's go ahead with our topic discussion. So I have a short presentation. I prepared some notes, some important points as well. So let's go ahead. So first and foremost, caries, dental caries, as you're all familiar with, this is something which we'll be dealing right from our first year videos, more or less, in one way or the other. The first and foremost, dental caries, the good news is even though it's a disease, it is something which is preventable. I'm not talking about treatment, but preventive aspect. So dental caries is preventable, chronic, and biofilm mediated disease, which is modulated by diet. In fact, if you say that a particular person has cariogenic biofilm, look at the modified Keyes-Jordan diagram. If a particular person has cariogenic biofilm and host, that is the tooth structure, and if he consumes fermentable carbohydrates, and if there is adequate time, we just can't say there will be dental caries for sure, because in most of us, when all of these four factors are being met, we still don't have dental caries, which means, or which only proves the fact that dental caries is a complex, multifactorial disease. And as you can see, we have listed so many primary and secondary modifying factors as given in Sturdivant. So first of all, initially, we had only three factors, and then time was added, and At the point of intersection of these four circles is nothing but your dental caries, coupled with these modifying factors. So along with these four factors, these modifying factors, and also protective factors, which we'll see in caries balance in the next slide. And right, so first and foremost, as you can see, the four factors which constitute modified Keyes diagram, modified Keyes Jordan diagram, that is host, which is nothing but your tooth structure, the cariogenic biofilm with acidgeric as well as acidophilic microorganisms, fermentable carbohydrates. I mean, we just can't say carbohydrates, they have to be fermentable. Fermentable carbohydrates, and using this, we're also using non-fermentable or other modes to prevent or treat dental caries. And also time is a very important factor. So with time, there can be, we're talking about demineralization and remineralization. So first and foremost, whenever these factors or criteria meet, caries is not just something which happens instantaneously. And there is always a constant demineralization and remineralization happening on surface and subsurface level, on tooth structure, which is very, very important for us to understand. Because with these factors, what's happening is the pH is being lowered in the biofilm ecosystem. So once the pH is lowered, we have something called as critical pH. So once the pH is lowered, then we see something called as demineralization. In order to maintain that integrity or homogeneity, the calcium and phosphate, as you know, leach out of the tooth structure and enter into this biofilm, form a supersaturated solution. And again, there can be potential remineralization once the pH balance is restored. So there is constant dynamic demineralization, remineralization happening within oral cavity, on surface of tooth, also at subsurface level. And there are several modifying factors, as you can see, which influence caries progression. So the primary modifying factors are the tooth anatomy, saliva, biofilm pH, biofilm composition, use of fluorides, diet specifics, oral hygiene, immune system, and genetic factors. Of these, usually we have questions from the pH aspect and also from fluorides. So that will be the focus of our MCQs discussion in tonight's dinner session. We'll look into more aspects in our dinner session regarding these specific topics. And there are secondary modifying factors which cannot be neglected or ignored. You have socioeconomic status, education, lifestyle, environment, age, ethnic group, occupation, which is very, very interesting. So this only proves the fact that it's not just these four factors which you see in the center of your screen that directly cause caries, but there are so many other modifying factors which again have been categorized as primary and secondary. Most importantly, one should understand the fact that there is always a constant process of demineralization and remineralization. Just because we don't have cavities doesn't mean that there is no demineralization happening. The moment you have some food, immediately, as per studies, immediately after your intake of food, the pH is lowered. But along with these other factors, right? If there is, these contributing factors for a longer time, then eventually demineralization further leads to cavitation. And that's when we talk about the treatments, right? The curative treatments like restorations and all, which we'll see in our evening session. Now, let's move on to the next slide. But before that, I want you to keep these factors in mind. Yes, of course, I want you to memorize them as well. And modified Keyes Jordan diagram, consider this very, very important. Okay, now let's move on to the next slide. As you can see, the caries balance. So again, we had previously several questions, MCQs from the same, especially regarding the protective factors. You can look into the right part of your screen. The last point, strategies that modulate dysbiotic microbiome, tin, antimicrobial, silver peptide. So there are questions regarding specific ions which have protective role in caries. So first and foremost, we can see pathologic factors and protective factors. So if there is any imbalance between them, if there are more of pathologic factors than protective factors, obviously it leads to more demineralization, ultimately cavitation. Vice versa, we don't see caries, right? So what are various pathologic factors? So acid producing bacteria, as you know, we constantly discuss about Streptococcus mutans, Lactobacillus, Actinomycetes. We have so many microorganisms. Even though we primarily focus on Streptococcus mutans or MS, again, we have serotypes in that. And also subnormal saliva flow and or function, usually seen with increase in age, burning mouth syndrome associated with various salivary gland pathologies, or even simply increase in age and also various pharmacological agents, even various medications, right? So frequent eating or drinking of fermentable carbohydrates is another. Even this is considered as a pathologic factor, right? See, food taken in moderation is essential for survival, but you know, misuse or overuse of anything, it can be simply called a pathology. So frequent eating or drinking of fermentable carbohydrates, and look at poor oral hygiene. So oral hygiene is something which we all focus. And anyways, we'll get back to that as well. Because as a dentist, it's not just oral hygiene we should be talking about. We have other important aspects also, which has been highlighted to a drastic extent in standard literature too. Not just oral hygiene, also the lifestyle modifications, the eating habits and all. So first and foremost, we've seen the pathologic factors. And coming to various protective factors, saliva flow and components. The beauty of human physiology is innately or inherently, our saliva has so many important functions, including protective role against dental caries. So that's the reason why when there is compromise in either quality or quantity of saliva, you find various pathologies, including dental caries. What about remineralization? So fluoride, calcium, phosphate. So yeah, so remineralization, using these agents, you might have heard of ACP and CPP. Tooth mouse, we call it as tooth mouse. You might have come across the same in periodontics. So agents which promote remineralization, good oral hygiene, in my opinion, good oral hygiene should be placed at top. But anyways, it's one of the protective factors. Strategies that maintain healthy microbiome, like probiotics, prebiotics, pH modifiers, xylitol and erythritol. So again, xylitol, we had questions previously. So again, these are considered as strategies which maintain healthy microbiome and strategies that modulate dysbiotic microbiome. So silver, peptide, stin, and antimicrobials. Need not go in depth about regarding the mechanism of actions, but at least be familiar with these strategies and to have a comprehensive understanding of how caries progression happens and the factors which actually play a role in either caries progression or prevention. Right now, finally, I just have the following questions for you and consider them very, very important in entrance point of view. And also, of course, those are attending university exams as well or Viva. So critical thinking. First and foremost, you know what critical pH is. So pH below which there will be rapid demineralization. And this is something which we are really concerned about as a dentist, as a oral healthcare provider. And we the preventive aspects are mainly focused on maintaining this pH balance for that matter. So what is a critical pH for enamel and dentin? Because enamel and dentin, they're composite structures which demineralize or which undergo demineralization at different pH, given their diversity in composition. So there is a variation. So what's the critical pH for enamel and dentin? Please refer to Irwin's or any standard textbook as per your convenience and availability and get back through mail because this is your final critical thinking assignment of 5 AM session. So second question, what's the relation between dental caries, MMPs and chlorhexidine? You might not find it in any standard textbook, but at least refer standard literature. I'm sure you can find it in Karenza. You can go through that. So anyways, what's the relation between caries, matrix metalloproteinases, chlorhexidine? What you might assume, what nonsense are we talking about? But strangely, there is a relation. There is a relation between caries and MMPs. Interrelation, rather, I can say. And also, there is an interrelation between MMPs and chlorhexidine. Thus, there is an interrelation between caries and chlorhexidine. So what is this all about? See if you can find out any link. It's going to be interesting, and also consider it very, very important. And finally, a clinical oriented question, which again will try to focus in a different way in our MCQs discussion. Does restorative treatment cure caries process? So we're giving a crown, or replacing a restoration, or replacing an onlay inlay in an attempt to replace the missing tooth structure if it is lost by caries process. So does this restorative treatment cure caries process? Just because you're doing restoration, can you call it as curing caries? So see if you can answer this question as well. And it's going to be very interesting, right? So three questions for your critical thinking assignment. I hope it's clear. Yeah, very good. Very good, Hadi. And but the values vary with enamel and dentin. Anyways, try finding out values for dentin as well. So I'm glad we had this 5 a.m. session. So our seventh day 5 a.m. club, I'm really glad that you guys joined, and it's no easy task. Waking up early in the morning, first thing. And second thing, that too on Monday, because Sunday is usually considered to be a day where we should have fun, more of fun, and you know, sleep as late as possible. But I'm really glad that you guys joined even on Monday, which really shows your enthusiasm. Just keep this consistency and momentum going. Regarding future live sessions, fate, we'll discuss them in our evening session. And evening, we'll have MCQs discussion from various topics relevant to these areas, like caries, demineralization, critical pH, fluorides, areas where we frequently see multiple choice questions. And also in the process, we'll discuss some background information as well. So wish you all the best. Love you all. Have a fantastic day ahead. And keep giving your best, right? Hi, Ahmed. A very good morning. Tejal, hi. A very good morning, Tejal. Ahmed, any videos about head and neck dental materials and oral pathology? Yes, you can, Ahmed, check out our e-classes. Do get back through mail at proudtobedentist@gmail.com for all details. Hi, Swadina. A very good morning. Felicio, hi. Hi, Hadi. Dr. Nidhi, Vasuki, Rashmi. Sumanta. Hi, Sumanta. Very good morning. Hi, Ritu. Yeah. Okay, guys. So take care. We'll see you tonight at 7:30 p.m. IST.